Hello and welcome. We are jumping into Photoshop today as usual, but I've got a really fun picture today because this is a very all-natural image and one that I loved creating, but maybe for reasons that are different than it seems. So yes, it was really fun. I remember very specifically making this picture, laying in the dirt, and somebody walked past and just could not believe that I was laying in the dirt. And that's like the most normal of things that I do on a daily basis. So it's always fascinating to me when somebody thinks that I'm totally weird for doing something that I think is way more normal than the things I could be doing. So I remember this day really well because of that. And I wanted to make a supernatural looking image, just laying on the ground, all natural colors, really almost like just sepia tone, beautiful. And this is what I came up with. But it's one of my favorite images to look at because it was created in such a weird, simple way. These little pieces of branches that you see here were actually just like little dead, you know, sticks all around and things like that, like quite normal looking. Not white, not any particular anything. And so let me show you how this started if we go down to the beginning. Just like that. I found this little area with lots of cool sticks. I added some to it. I expanded my frame. And so you can see that a couple things aren't working here right off the bat. The branches don't stand out at all. I am not wearing the right color dress for what I wanted to do, so those things have to be changed. And I started to move my body into place. Let's take a look at this real quick, because I was off. Like, I was laying crooked, and so I actually used the warp tool to just make it look like my dress was straighter and laying flat on the earth. Now this is the fun part. Okay, this is the best part of this whole edit to me. It's this part here where I'm taking my dodge tool and using it as a creative effect. Now, I'm told that the dodge and burn tools in Photoshop are largely used for skin retouching. I know nothing about this, like at all. So I use it for weird creative things. One of them is this. Another would be enhancing ribs or like, you know, like someone's backbone or something like that. Creating 3D effects where there weren't any to begin with. I've done it so many times. So this is one of my favorite things. So let me show you how I do this. If I go over to my burn tool and I just hold down on that, I get the dodge tool and vice versa. I'm gonna click on my layer 5, and so I'm on my dodge tool. The dodge tool makes things brighter. When you run over it like a brush, it will make things brighter. So if I start doing it on my face, it's gonna make my face brighter. And if I take the exposure all the way up, you can really see what it's doing, really making it brighter. But right now I have it set to the range of shadows, and if it's set on shadows, it's going to mostly affect the shadows, same with midtones. So if I do this with my midtones, it's gonna be even more, right? Because my face falls into the midtones, and same with highlights. So let's go ahead and keep it on midtones for the sake of showing this. I'm using my left square bracket to make my brush smaller. And I'm just going to start to run over with my mouse or with my pen, because I'm on a touch screen here. I'm just running over where I want the branches to be brighter. You can do this with a really small brush for a finer point. There we go. And so I am just making this look exactly how I want by drawing it in. So much fun. And you can create such amazing separation in these branches from the background, from how they were. I mean, just those steps that we just did, like look at that. Such a huge difference. And so that's what I ended up doing for this picture. I ended up going in and really taking my time to figure out which sticks I wanted to stand out from the background. That was the most fun part of this edit. All right, so we're darkening, starting to figure this frame out. And you'll notice like we're missing a big part of the frame down here. That was the dress color. And by the way, with the dress color, you know, in the past we've always done replace color. Replace color doesn't work on an image like this because the dress color is so pale, too similar to my skin tone. So I just went with my lasso tool and selected all around the dress and created a curve adjustment layer to change the color there. But the frame is all wrong here, right? I create squares. I knew that I wanted this amount of space above, so I wanted to create more below. And this is what I did. I stretched the image. Oh no, I stretched the image. I know, everyone freaks out about this. And yes, it's going to mean that I can't print this image as large as other images, but within reason, right? Like, I will be able to print it still pretty darn big. And I don't mind the distortion. So there's the final distortion, and I would have left it there if I wanted to be able to print really large, but I went even further because I liked the way that it looked like it was sucking it underground, like they were roots going into the earth. That, to me, made the concept even more interesting. And so in order to put concept above technique, I went and I stretched it. Oh well. So I've added a couple more branches, brightening it up, just finishing up the image, creating more interest all around, and done. So that's this image. It can be so simple, right? Like, sometimes these tools in Photoshop, like the dodge tool, that we don't know how to use or we've always used for one particular purpose, can be used for really amazing, fun things. And that's what I love about Photoshop, is just exploring and seeing how far I can take something, and if I can do it in my own way that brings me joy. Because if your process doesn't bring you joy, then why create at all? I hope you have a wonderful creative week. Bye, guys.